Hi, welcome back to Rebecca's Travels, or if you're watching my lifestyle channel, hi, welcome back to Rebecca's Lifestyle. How are you all doing? I hope everybody's as well as possible. Today I'm going to be showing you outside at Chartwell House, where at Winston, at Churchill and his family lived, and around the area outside. Again, there's lots to do for 4 days stay, or a 4 days visit in the summer. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe, and a big thumbs up and thank you for doing so. I really appreciate it. So let's jump right into it. Now, this is just outside at the visitor centre. Members to the garden only that way. You pay at the entrance, house and garden, and it gives you tickets and information. There's also a small shop inside there and a disabled WC and baby changing. And there's also some National Trust seats to sit on. There's some plants on sale, and then further up there is a shop. The plants are absolutely beautiful, and there's some toilets if you need to go to the toilet. Next door, there's a second hand box shop. And some seating areas outside. There's also toilets and lockers. And then that's entrance into the cafe. This is the exit. This is the cafe. You can sit inside and outside. It depends on the weather. Then there's car parking and bins as well. You're allowed to take dogs around the gardens. There's the cafe inside there. So there's ample range of parking. There's a mobility bus. If you do struggle with mobility, that actually takes you to the house. Going down here, there's bike parking places. That's private. And going back to nature, some information on the nature: hedgehogs, bees, moths, butterflies, frogs, toads, newts, grass, snakes, slow worms, birds and wild flowers. There's also a lovely pond in the making. Then there's general waste and mixed recycling points, dog waste only. And then we've got a beautiful tree here. The tulips look absolutely gorgeous. And the daisies. Dogs are welcome on short leads. Garden tour at 2 p.m. today. And also, it tells you about volunteering. Winston Churchill's favourite object. Where to exit, the different exits. Quebec House, Toys Hill, Emmett's Garden. It has a television to show you around the house. Or some pictures around the house. And these are the prices and the parking for non-members and all the gift aid admissions. This gives you a map and also the admissions there and opening times, and it's part of the National Trust. What's on the day celebrations? So now I'm going to show you the beautiful garden. There's a shed here. The landscape is absolutely gorgeous as well. On a sunny day, it'd look absolutely really beautiful, I can imagine, because it always, well, it's looking really beautiful now, a bench to sit down on, some National Trust gardeners. Lots of benches to sit down. Then the woodland is that way. Access to woodlands and play areas, use this path. And then the house and gardens this way. There's a beautiful black dock here. Please keep your distance from the black swans and our wildlife. There's a beautiful tree and pond. Lots of trees, different types of trees, which is always good to see. Those of you not interested in history, I think would love it here if you're interested in wildlife. And obviously, if you're interested in history, you would love it here as well. This is a lovely stream. And we have a little bridge that goes over it. There's some rhubarb here. There's a lake with the black swans inside the lake up there. It is uphill, but if you do struggle with walking, then you can get a minibus up here. It's about 300 to 600 meters. Again, you can get tour guides around the house and the garden as well. Ooh, let's have a look what's here. Another pond, it looks like. Oh, and a bit of a waterfall. How nice. And there's an elegant seat there as well, and some stepping stones. Here's a close-up of the waterfall. I don't think we can see any fish or animals in this pond. And then the gardens and studio were that way, house entrance that way, way out, cafe and shop this way. So it is really well signposts. This tree is Crepitamena japonica, which is Japanese cider tree. It's thought to have been planted in 1852. Please help us to conceive its life by not climbing on it. So no climbing on the Japanese cider tree. This is another pond, and yes, we can see some fish. It looks like a tropical fish there, and there, and a few more up there. All swimming around, lots of fish. Then we go up some steps to another pond. Absolutely lots of ponds. And a bit of a waterfall as an elegant feature. Some more fish. And it looks like they're feeding the fish as well. Is just go up the steps. This is where the minibus takes you. And again, there's some more seating. And, oh, the doors are closing now, because the minibus has just arrived. And it looks like you go into the house this way. Again, plenty of seating and plants. There's the minibus. My tour starts between 11:30 and 11:40 of the house. It's really, I think this is staff car parking. The Churchillis was purchased in 1922. But yes, I think it's an absolute great day out. And it's got things to do for when it's raining, like today partly. And plenty of toilets around by the looks of things as well, and seating. Wow, I've just got so much to say about this place, and there's a lot to do. Lots of different types of plants and trees. Family pet graves. There's some toilets. I'm going down these steps now. To get a bit nearer to the gardens. They look absolutely beautiful. And that looks like the studio house at the top there. Nice also to see the different trees planted on the walls of the house, different colours, and then we've got some lovely plant pots as well, some more tulips. But yes, that looks like the studio there. I don't think it's open today at the moment. That's another map with a key area. Last but not least today, I'll show you the rose garden, which absolutely looks beautiful. Even if you don't go inside the house, the gardens and all around the area is a beautiful walk. At Chartwell, also there's a playground for children as well. Wow, this is a long video. But there's just such a lot to show you.
Isn't that sure? Yeah.
this is the final part, which I'm going to show you, which is the rose garden. And again, there's some seating areas around here. And again, if it's raining, then there's some outdoor and indoor seating. There's different ways in and out. If you want to sit in inside, or maybe if there's a special event, because I know that they do events on here, this will be a nice room, very colourful. And some writing along the side as well. Again, a really big lake. There's a absolute gorgeous tree. The studio is this way. So that thing before that I showed you wasn't the studio. It's this way. And again, that must be the studio there. Sorry, I did get it wrong earlier. But anyway, we'll get a map anyway of the place if you do come. So I would like to say thank you for watching, and I'll see you for another video today of a quick review inside the house and my thoughts on the whole experience as a whole. And I would like to say thank you for watching, and bye for now. Thank you. Bye.